11-346-11-346 on lap one for Vic Hill and Orthopedic Institute of Western Kentucky. Land Air Transport Pilot Service Center sponsored. 11.320 up next in the 111. I hope, and we'll hold up just a moment. Your next qualifier in the 111 machine. He comes to you out of Gadsden, Alabama. That's Bo Shirley. Bo Shirley out of Gadsden, Alabama. He's 39 years of age in a CVR race car for the Talladega Short Track Regular, where we're going to be in a couple of weeks. His first lap time. 11-747-11-747 on lap one for Bo Shirley in the Nilco Welding Supply, sponsored at number 111 CVR race car. His second lap for Bo Shirley, 12.170, 12.170. Up next, in the blue and white, number four machine, former Atomic Speedway track champion out of Powell, Tennessee. That's Mark Vineyard. Mark Vineyard, 47 years of age, in a Warrior race car with a Vic Hill Racing engine. 11-686 on lap one for Mark Vineyard in the Smith Built Property sponsored number four Warrior race car. Second lap for Mark Vineyard, 11.642. Up next, former Southern All-Starter Racing Series champion and former Tazewell Speedway Superlay Model Track champion in the number 201 out of Knoxville, Tennessee, Billy the Kid, Billy Ogle Jr. Billy Ogle Jr. in the Larry Garner on Blount Motorsports Rocket chassis with a custom race engine making a horsepower. 11.332. Second quick so far for Billy Ogle Jr. in the Massey Electric Blount Excavating Alp Lincolnship Enterprises Cherokee Millwrights Stowers Cat Enterprises sponsored machine. His second lap, 11.318. And that is your new quick time in Group A. Up next in the black 44 out of Grays Court, South Carolina, it's Smokey Chris Madden. Chris Madden in a Team Bloomquist machine powered by a Clements Racing engine. He's 37 years of age. 11.099. A quick time so far for Chris Madden in the Century Plastics Henderson Amusements Hemricks of Gaffney sponsored Bloomquist race car. His second lap, 10.944. Quick time so far. Up next, currently fifth in series points in the black and white double deuce, the 22 out of Friendsville, Tennessee, the milkman Mike Weeks. Mike Weeks, it is on in the Lester Weeks on Rocket chassis at 11.550 on lap one for Mike Weeks in the JT Kerr Racing Equipment Airport Auto Auction Richardson Construction Crook Creek Body Shop Rocket PPM Racing Products Cruise with the champion sponsored machine at 11.426-11.426. Up next, currently second in series points coming into tonight's action at Tazewell Speedway in the R1 machine out of Chattanooga, Tennessee. It's Riley Hickman. Riley Hickman in his own Masters built race car with a Vic Hill race engine making a horsepower in lap one. 11.697, 11.697 on lap one for Riley Hickman in the Hickman Manufacturing, American Billet Austin Trucking, Whoopi Race Fuels, Rick Hickson Fabrication, Competition Race Products, sponsored machine. His second lap, 11.626, 11.626. Up next in his first Tazewell Speedway appearance, he was quickest in his hot lap group, the 12 out of Gray, Georgia. That's Hunter Peacock. Hunter Peacock, 25 years of age, in a Mike Knotsworthy owned GRT race car with a Roush Yates Ford race engine at 11.650 on lap one for Hunter Peacock in the Knotsworthy Mechanical Roush Yates race engines. FK Ride Ends Wolfpack race car sponsored number 12. His second lap, 11.688, 11.688. Up next, man needs no introduction at Tazewell Speedway here at AirWhitePerformance.com. Time trials in the number three out of Powell, Tennessee. That is Steve Smith. Steve Smith, 57 years of age, and the Dakota James owned C.J. Rayburn race car with a Phantom race engine making a horsepower at 12.910 on lap one for Steve Smith and a Hoosier Race Tire Rayburn Automotive Phantom race engine sponsored Rayburn. His second lap going to be much better at 11.461 as we continue on here in Group A of WhitePerformance.com time trials. The 15-year-old second generation driver up next in first Tazewell Speedway appearance, the H2 out of Mumford, Alabama. That's Brett Holmes. Brett Holmes, 15 years of age, in the Stacy Holmes on Barry Wright race car with a Cornette racing engine making a horsepower at 11.662. On lap one for Brett Holmes and the Holmes 2 excavation Jackson Mortgage sponsored Barry Wright race car for the 15-year-old out of Mumford, Alabama. Brett Holmes, His second lap better at 11.518, 11.518. Up next, very familiar with Tazewell Speedway and the Davy Allison lookalike 28. Out of Clinton, Tennessee, veteran Jeff Wolfenbarger. Jeff Wolfenbarger in his own Team Zero. Scott Blomquist chassis with a custom race engine making a horsepower. 11.520, 11.520. The time for Jeff Wolfenbarger. And the cool colors rod and custom sponsored Blomquist chassis for Jeff Wolfenbarger. His second lap better at 11.479, 11.479. And your next qualifier out, multi-time limited late model track champion here at Tazewell Speedway. In the good-looking number 90 J machine out of Powell, Tennessee, second-generation racer Jason Trammell. Jason Trammell and the Jack Trammell-owned C.J. Rayburn race car with a Big Hill race engine making a horsepower. His first lap of the evening, 11.656, 11.656 on lap one for Jason Trammell. And the Trammell Construction Company Fast Lane signs Hetmaker holding Solo Cup Body sponsored at number 90, Jay Rayburn, his second lap, 11.633, 11.633. Up next, yeah, the H3 machine. The driver comes to you out of Sunny Daisy, Tennessee. That's Kane Hickman. Kane Hickman, 24 years of age, in the Dwayne Hickman-owned performance race car with a Brian Hickman race engine. His first lap, 12.135, 12.135 on lap one for Kane Hickman. And the Paul's Body Shop, Paul's Auto Parts, of Sunny Daisy, Tennessee, sponsored machine. His second lap better at 11.960, 11.960. Up next, currently third in series points and leads the Rookie of the Year points in the one. Out of Oxford, Alabama, Jason Hyatt. Jason Hyatt, 29 years of age, in his own Warrior chassis with a Vinson racing engine making a horsepower. 11.901, 11901 on lap one for Jason Hyatt. And the Freestyle Graphics Old Man's Garage sponsored Warrior chassis for Jason Hyatt. His second lap better at 11.766, 11.766. And a Michael Chilton coming to the green flag has made contact with the outside retaining wall up in the turn three and four area. Young man had a top 10 finish in that brand new Revolution chassis up at the Indianapolis. To everyone in East Tennessee as well in the 11B machine out of Clinton, Tennessee. That is Stacy Bowles. Stacy Bowles, 44 years of age. Yeah, a Masters-built race car with a Big Hill race engine making a horsepower for Stacy Bowles, working off turn number four. His first lap, 11.786, 11.786 on lap one for Stacy Bowles in the Advanced Transport West Haven Speed Equipment, sponsored number 11B. Bowles coming down for lap number two. Here he is. Better at 11.625, 11.625, and that's your new quick time in Group B. Next. In the 17 machine, currently fifth in series points out of Rockford, Tennessee. That's Mark Rosner. Mark Rosner in the Stinger chassis, Stinger race car, house car with a Larry Wallace race engine making a horsepower at 11.955, 11.955 on lap one for Mark Rosner in the JT Kerr Racing Equipment, Kaiser Manufacturing, Inlow Enterprises, JBE Investment sponsored Stinger race car. His second lap better at 11.876, 11.876. Up next, another driver familiar to everyone here at Tazewell Speedway in the black nickel, the number five. He's out of Knoxville, Tennessee. That's Brian Hendricks. Brian Hendricks in his own Masters-built race car with a custom race engine. He's 48 years of age. His lap, 11.693, 11.693, third creek so far now in Group B. And the Moto Simpson, FK Rodians, JCM Components, Custom Race Engines, K&N Filters, JT Kerr Racing Equipment, sponsored entry. Quick time in Group B right there by Brian Hendricks, 11.419, 11.419 for Brian Hendricks. That's quick in Group B. Up next, in the number 63 machine, out of Knoxville, Tennessee, that's Josh Collins, 28 years of age in a Warrior race car with a Vic Hill race engine at 11.649, 11.649 on lap one for Josh Collins. Sponsored by Tyler Jenkins Racing, JCM Components, and Spectacular Salon. His second lap better at 11.600, 11.600. 0-0. Up next, second generation young gun in the red and black trim 25 out of Newport, Tennessee. It's the Jet, Josh Henry. Josh Henry, 22 years of age in the Pig Leg Motorsports on TNT race car with a Bill Kerr race engine at 11.759 on lap one for Josh Henry. And the little steam cleaning TNT race cars, Bill Kerr race engine sponsored machine for 22-year-old Josh Henry. His second lap, 11.917-119-17. And looks like the final qualifier of the night in WhitePerformance.com time trials in the yellow and black 4T out of Maryville, Tennessee. It's Tommy Kerr. Tommy Kerr and the Larry Garner owned Mount Motorsports Rocket Chassis with a custom race engine at 11.617. Third quick now in this group in the Massey Electric. Cherokee Millwright, Mount Excavating, Starris Cat Enterprises, Al Blankenship Enterprises, sponsored number 4T, 11.456, 11.456, and that is second quick in Group B. Tazewell Speedway. Steve Smith and Jeff Wolfenbarger in row one, Brett Holmes and Riley Hickman in row two, Mark Vineyard and Hunter Peacock make up row number three, 10 laps. The winner starts ninth in the Charles Trammell Memorial. Eyes on him off turn number four, green flags down, and here we go. Steve Smith got to jump out here to the early lead, Jeff Wolfenbarger second. Brett Holmes into Stacy Hoes on the H2, rides in the third spot, Mark Vineyard got to be fourth. With Riley Hickman, fifth, Hunter Peacock, sixth. Meanwhile, up front, Steve Smith and Jeff Wolfenbarger putting some distance between the battle for third now between the four, Mark Vineyard and the H2 of Brett Holmes. They're door-to-door off turn four down the front straightaway. Give the third spot to Mark Vineyard now down into turn number one, but he slips up a bit as the front two of Steve Smith and Jeff Wolfenbarger scoot away from the field. As we've got three laps in the book, seven to go in PPM Racing Products. Last chance, showdown number one. Smith the leader, Wolfenbarger second. Vineyard third. There goes the R1 of Riley Hickman by the H2 of Brett Holmes into the fifth spot. And Hunter Peacock trying to do the same as Holmes. Looks like he's fighting a tight condition on that race car. Put Hunter Peacock into position number five. Pound, Tennessee, Steve Smith continuing to show the way. With five in the books, five to go in PPM Racing Products. Last chance, showdown at number one. It's all Steve Smith out in front. Jeff Wolfenbarger continues to hold down second. Mark Vineyard setting in the third spot. Riley Hickman fourth, and Hunter Peacock trying to find a way around Riley Hickman as they race off into turn number three. Seven in the books, three to go. It's all Steve Smith out in front right now for a Saturday night stroll beneath the stars here at Tazewell Speedway. Eight in the books, two to go in PPM Racing Products. Last chance showdown number one. Smith continues to show the way with Wolfenbarger in second as they'll come to Bruce Kaler's white flag. One lap to go in PPM Racing Products. Last chance showdown number one. Steve Smith working at Rayburn Chassis down the back straightaway into turn three. He'll bring it down to the checkered flag. Pout, Tennessee, Steve Smith, the winner of PPM Racing Products. Last chance showdown number one. Jeff Wolfenbarger will go second before Mark Vineyard will come home in third. Fourth will go to the 12 of Hunter Peacock. With fifth going to the R1 of Riley Hickman and then the H2 of Brett Holmes. Your top three finishers in PPM Racing Products last chance showdown number one, third to four of Mark Vineyard. Second, the 28 of Jeff Wolfenbarger. And grabbing the win in PPM Racing Products, B main number, last chance showdown, I should say, number one. In his own C.J. Rayburn race car powered by a Phantom Racing engine, the 57-year-old veteran in the Dakotas, James owned a Rayburn, sponsored by Hoosier Race Tire, C.J. Rayburn race cars and Phantom Race engines out of Powell, Tennessee. Big round of applause for Steve Smith. Second generation pilots on the front row of this one. The 90J of Jason Trammell, the 25 of Josh Henry. Eyes on him. Bruce Kaler's green flag is out. And we're underway in PPM Racing Products. Last chance showdown number two. But Jason Trammell on the point. Josh Henry second. Jason Hyatt's going to be third. Mark Rosner fourth. And Kane Hickman going to ride in position number five as we've got one lap in the book. Nine to go. And Hyatt looking to the inside of Henry. The youngster's going at it for the bridesmaid spot to second position down into turn number three. Hyatt on the bottom trying to get clear of Henry for the runner-up slot. He's got it done down into turn number one. And he gets sideways. Hyatt got sideways and may have had some help there from Josh Henry. And that's going to draw the caution flag. Caution is out for the runner-up spot. And Hyatt got a little crossed up there in the center of turns one and two. Third, Kane Hickman fourth. When Jason Hyatt will restart in fifth. Eyes out up here off turn four. Green's back out of hand. We're back underway in PPM Racing Products. Last chance showdown number two. Rosner looking to the inside of Henry. They're side by side for the runner-up spot down in the turn number three. Rosner on the bottom. Henry up top coming at you down the front straightaway. All that going on behind race leader Jason Trammell. Rosner fires a slider up in front of Henry off turn two. Grabs the runner-up spot while Jason Hyatt's gone back into position number four. Henry trying to make a move on Rosner down in three and four. Not able to make it stick. And now here comes Jason Hyatt in the number H1. He'll look but eight Henry now for the turn number three. Hyatt with a fast hot ride tonight. The Oxford, Alabama native spun while running second, and he's going to grab the second spot away from Mark Rosner. Look at the young man go out of Oxford, Alabama. Meanwhile, up front it is all Jason Trammell out of Powell, Tennessee, continuing to show the way with six laps in the books in PPM Racing Products, BMA number two. Trammell with about a half straightaway over second place running Jason Hyatt. Mark Rosner's third. Josh Henry holds down the fourth position. Kane Hickman rides in fifth. Jason Trammell will put lap number eight up on the Coca-Cola scoreboard. Dead in turn number one, two to go in PPM Racing Products. Last chance showdown number two. White flag in the air. One lap to settle the issue in PPM Racing Products. Last chance showdown number two. Jason Trammell into turn three for the final time off of turn number four. Powell, Tennessee's Jason Trammell, the winner of this one. Jason Hyatt will come home in second. Mark Rosner will finish third. Fourth, we'll go to Josh Henry with fifth, going to Kane Hickman. Your top three finishers finishing third to 17 of Mark Rosner. Second, the H1. Jason Hyatt and grabbing the win in PPM Racing Products last chance showdown number two. It is in the Jack Trammell owned C.J. Rayburn race car powered by a Vic Hill race engine sponsored by Trammell Construction Company, Fastlane Signs, Hatmaker Holding, and Solo Cup Bodies. 37 years of age out of Powell, Tennessee. Big round of applause for Jason Trammell.
Blanken and Davis pick up the pace. Field bunches up behind him on the back stretch. Looking for the signal from flagman Bruce Kaler this time by. Green is in the air. We are underway here at the bad, fast Tazewell Speedway on that fresh stretch. Neck and neck, going to turns one and two down the back stretch. It is a dog race there. Brad Davis pulls right in front of Gary Blake. It gets a push from Robbie Buchanan. Gets sideways now. Robbie Buchanan makes contact with Dakota Knuckles. That'll bring out the caution. Caution on lap number one. There we go, looking for another, for a clean start here. Flag is in the air. And we're back underway. Modified street 20 lap feature. Now still, there's Brad Davis pulling ahead of Blanket going down the back stretch. Robbie Buchanan trying to settle in the third. He's got Dakota Knuckles all over his back bumper. Coming to complete lap number one. It's Brad Davis, Gary Blanken, Robbie Buchanan, and Ance Knuckles, and Tony Horton. Brad Davis trying to settle that 88 car into a good groove. He's got a bumper full of Gary Blanken. Two laps in the books. It's Brad Davis, Gary Blanken. About three car lengths back. In third position is Robbie Buchanan. Looks like everybody's trying to use that high groove so far early in the going. Brad Davis out of Tazewell, Tennessee. Car sponsored by Old Town Grill, A1 Tent and Detail, and Andrews Construction. Coming around complete lap number four. Davis to your leader now. Gary Blanket snuck down to the inside. Couldn't get the advantage. And that will let Blanken slip, or Davis slip ahead a few car lengths as we got a caution over in turn number two. Caution comes out on lap number four. And it looks like Dakota Knuckles, one machine pit side. And track officials going over to check on. Looking for the green next time by. Four laps down, 16 more to go. And we're back underway. Now Gary Blanken goes all the way down to the bottom groove, trying to get himself under Brad Davis. Nothing doing. That will let Robbie Buchanan catch up to the back bumper of Gary Blanken as they come around to complete lap number five, fourth of the way down in this feature. Now Gary Blanken slowed over turn number one. Buchanan made contact. Now he's got problems. Robbie Buchanan slowing down the field. Now we see smoke coming out of the 52 of Michael Boyd. Caution comes out. Problems for the P21 of Robbie Buchanan. So Buchanan was running third. And Gary Blanken went into turn number one and slowed. And Buchanan made contact, and after that, he slowed. And so Petty Motorsports on the P21 car taking line over hole fourth. Now we got the 21K of Dakota Knuckles. He slowed on the front stretch, the fifth spot, as Robbie Buchanan will join the tail end of the field. Five laps down, 15 more to go. Green is back in the air. We're underway. Gary Blanken gives chase to Brad Davis. Davis with about a two-car length advantage going down the back stretch. Gary Blanken with a little bit of advantage when they go into the turns. Now they're side-by-side in a flagman stand. Door-to-door going into turn number one. Give the advantage to Gary Blanken as he's still trying to slip in front. Now here goes Davis backside. Makes contact. Makes contact on the back stretch. Blanken able to hold on to the lead. What a move on that last lap by Gary Blanken. They were door-to-door at the flagman stand. And Blanken was able to slip under the low side and take the lead away from Brad Davis. Gary Blanken now trying to pull away from the 88 of Brad Davis. Four car length advantage as they go down the back stretch. Coming around to complete lap number 10. Halfway down. Eleven laps in the book. Gary Blanken your leader. Brad Davis second. Tony Horton third. Clyde Overholt in fourth, and Larry Burke holding on to the fifth spot. Now Brad Davis, as he came out of turn number two, it got sideways for a moment. And now Gary Blanken with almost a full straightaway length advantage over second place Brad Davis. 13 down. Seven more to go. Coming around for the white flag, Gary Blingen takes the white flag from flagman Bruce Kaler. Let's hear for your Rabada 5 Street feature win tonight, Gary Blanket on Horsetown. And Gary gets a graduation there. Six wins last season. Last week you had a little bit of bad luck. Yeah. No bad luck tonight. Tell us about that move you put on Brad Davis on laps.
Well, I seen he was getting a little bit loose and the track's starting to dry out a little bit. He was getting a little looser and looser. And I know if I could go in the wet down there, mine would stick, and I had a good idea I could get him as long as he stayed in the dry and I could get in the wet.
And you did well. You had six wins last season. Good way to start off the 2013 season.
I appreciate it. I appreciate all the fans up there cheering for me. I want to thank Frankie and them for this old car. He built a good car, and them old boys work on it. Good race. They work on it hard out there. They worked till 4 o'clock in the morning last night getting this thing ready to go.
And now you go celebrate.
I want to thank Travis Fultz, wherever he's at. He built a dang good motor in this thing. That thing had the power tonight.
You had the power tonight. One more time, folks, here for your winner, Gary Blanket in a modified street. Got your four-cylinder feature. Southern All-Stars need to be getting ready for your feature. Former four-cylinder champion, Chuck McMahon takes the lead away from pole sitter Hasten Collette on lap number two. Now he's setting sail. Now the 14 car, Chad Manning, now he battles Hasten Collette for the second spot, takes that away from him. Chad Manning in the 14, that Pinto, and he'll try to set his sights on race leader Chuck McMahon. So Hasten Collette was your third fastest qualifier. He started on the front row and quickly lost that lead to Chuck McMahon. Now McMahon with about an 8-car length advantage over second place. Chad Manning, Hasten Collette in third, Mark Wallace fourth, and Bubby Braden your top five. 8 laps down, 7 more to go. Former track champion Chuck McMahon holding court right now. 2-time Tazewell Speedway 4-cylinder champion. Now, Chuck McMahon comes up on the left car, 72 Rufus Collette. Quickly puts him behind him. 10 laps down, 5 more to go for Chuck McMahon. Chuck McMahon got that 99 car in cruise control. 11 down, four more to go. And just as Chuck McMahon takes the white flag, we've got a caution as James Collette Jr. makes hard contact with the outside wall in turn number four. And that will bring out the caution. Southern All-Stars Late Models, you are up. One to go flag. Chuck McMahon coming around to take the green. 13 down, two more to go. White flag is in the air. One more lap for Chuck McMahon. Here comes that first. Let's give a hand for your winner tonight, Chuck McMahon in the 99. Is she a little bit camera shy?
Not a little bit.
Hey, man, we knew it would take too long for you to get that 99 back up front. It took you a couple laps there chasing on Hasten, but you put the move on him and put the 99 back in victory lane, brother.
Yeah, I got to thank everybody that's helped me get this car back together. We just drug it out Tuesday this week and pieced it back together. Tyler Woodson, Bob Russell, and all the guys that helped me, Kurt Owens, just everybody helps me. I couldn't do it without them. Jim Ford's Machine Shop.
Say, good job, Daddy.
Good job, Dad.
All right, folks, give a hand for your winner tonight, Chuck McMahon in the 99.
On your feet, race fans, the four breast parade lap to salute to you. Great race fans of East Tennessee here at Tazewell Speedway. Green flag in hand, flags up, we're going green next time by. With the Southern All-Star Dirt Racing Series here at Tazewell Speedway, the fourth annual Charles Trammell Memorial. You bought your whole seat, but you're probably only going to need the edge for this one. Chris Smokey Madden and Brian Hendricks set to bring up the green eyes on them. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime! And Hendricks hard in the wall up at turn number one. And that's going to draw the caution flag. Oh, my gosh, tough break for Brian Hendricks. Steered into the hot pit area here in the center of the infield. Tough, tough break for that young man. He was the fastest qualifier in Group B, and that put him on the outside of the front row. But that will change the complexion of one to go. Signal being shown. We'll be going to green next time by. So that'll put Chris Smokey Madden and Tommy Kerr up on the front row. Billy Ogle Jr. And Josh Collins now in row two. Vic Hill and Stacy Bowles will make up row three. Mike Weeks and Jason Trammell in row four. Steve Smith and Jason Hyatt will make up row number five. Eyes on them as they'll pull the trigger and smash a loud pedal here to Bad Fast Taz. Here we go. Off of turn number two, Chris Madden jumps to the top spot. Billy Ogle Jr. is going to be second. Vic the Thrill Hill up to third. Tommy Kerr going to be fourth. Here comes the milkman Mike Weeks on the bottom. He's in fifth. He has a couple of cars together here on the front straightaway. Jason Trammell, along with the three of Steve Smith, and he's going to draw the caution. Caution is out. They may have got them hung together there. And Trammell may have a flat left rear tire on his machine. Nope, no, it is up. next time by. Again, the Delaware Double File restarts the leader out front all by himself. The second place car gets to choose whether he wants to start inside or outside as they get ready to pull the trigger here off turn four. Green flag back out underway again here at Tazewell Speedway. Tommy Kerr going to grab the third spot from Big Hill as Billy Ogle looks to the inside of Chris Madden. They'll battle for the lead inches apart off turn number four as we'll get a lap number two up on the Coca-Cola scoreboard. Madden the leader, Ogle in second, Kerr third, Vic Hill now looks beneath Tommy Kerr. That's for the third spot, but not able to make the move there off turn four. Hill will stay in fourth, Mike Weeks fifth, Stacy Bowles is sixth, Josh Collins seventh, Chip Wolfenberger eighth, Mark Vineyard ninth, Jason Hyatt tenth. Madden works down the front straightaway. They will put lap four up on the board. And it looks like the preferred line, they've got out of the black at the top and starting to work the moisture and down in the bottom of the racing surface now. Madden leading the way with Ogle about a car length and a half off his back bumper. Then it's about eight car lengths back to the battle for third between the 14 of Tommy Kerr and the one of Vic Hill. Hill to the inside of Kerr. Through wheel down to turn number one. That's for the third spot. As the leaders go around the small car, the 8th spirit King Hickman down the back straightaway. Kerr will keep Hill at bay for the time being. Meanwhile, up front, Chris Madden and Billy Ogle Jr. continue to duel for the top spot, working off turn two down the back straightaway. Now they'll come up on the slower car, Brent Holmes, as they exit turn four and get ready to put lap number eight on the scoreboard. Eight down, 42 to go. Madden looks to the inside of Holmes. He'll put him a lap down. Ogle will try to do the same down in turn three and four, and he will. As the 14 of Tommy Kerr now starting to close in on the front duo of Madden and Ogle Jr. down the back straightaway into turn number three. Madden now trying to negotiate the slower car of Josh Henry as they work into turn number one. We've got 10 in the books, a fifth of the way home in this one. Madden now looks beneath Josh Henry. He'll put him a lap down as they work off turn number four. The front four almost nose to tail now down the front straightaway as they set him down into turn number one. Madden the leader, Ogle Jr. second, Kerr third, Vic Hill fourth, and the 22 of Mike Weeks is fifth, Stacy Bowles sixth, Josh Collins seventh, Mark Vineyard eighth, Jeff Wolfenberger rides in ninth. Your race leader, Chris Madden, now working off turn number four. They'll put lucky lap number 13 on the scoreboard that time, 13 down, 37 to go as race leader Madden tries to negotiate the slower car. Bo Shirley, he'll step to the outside up on the top shelf in turn three and four and put the 111 of Bo Shirley a lap down. Meanwhile, Billy Ogle getting some pressure from teammate Tommy Kerr for the runner-up slot. The Blount Motorsports Machines running second and third with Victor Thrill Hill sitting in the fourth spot. Madden now sets his sights on the next car. He'll attempt to put a lap down, and that is the 17 by Mark Rosner. As they work down the front straightaway, Madden will have him cleared down into turn number one with 16 in the books, 34 to go. Madden, the leader, Billy Ogle Jr. second, Tommy Kerr third, those three almost nose to tail. We got caution. Caution is out. It's Collins. Eighth looks to be the four, Mark Vineyard. Ninth, the 28 of Jeff Wolfenberger. And the final car in the top 10 at this point, the 12 of Hunter Peacock. And Billy Ogle Jr., the second place car, will choose the inside of the first Delaware double file restart row. As everyone starts to... Beautiful Saturday evening. The 16 in the books, eyes on them as they'll smash the loud pedal once again off turn four. Here we go. Ogle and Kerr duking it out for the second spot as Vic Hill and Mike Weeks battle for fourth and fifth here on the restart. Ogle looking to the inside of Madden, not able to make a move as Vic Hill grabbed the third spot away from Tommy Kerr off turn four there. Josh Collins out of shape here, and Jeff Wolfenberger loses several spots down the back straightaway, dropping out of the top 10 now. Meanwhile, Madden getting heat from Billy Ogle Jr. for the top spot down into turn number three. Vic Hill sets third, Tommy Kerr fourth. Stacy Bowles now into fifth in the 11B. Ogle to the inside of Madden. They're side by side for the lead. Madden's momentum off the top side keeps Ogle at bay for the time being, but
Billy the Kid looks like he's got a fast hot rod. Can he do anything with Smokey here in this one? With 20 down, 30 to go. Madden and Ogle duking it out into turns three and four. Hills third, Kerr fourth, Bowles fifth, Weeks sixth, Vineyard seventh. Peacock is eighth, Collins ninth, and Jason Hyatt, the final car in the top 10. The front four work down into turn three and four now. Ogle right up. Oh, Madden slows. So we got caution. Caution is out. There's on Josh Henry's number 25. As the field, it gets stacked up two by two, double file behind a race leader, Chris Madden. We're getting ready to do it again. Eyes on him on turn four, and here we go. Madden leads the parade off turn two down the back straightaway. Billy Ogle Jr., second. Tommy Kerr working back to the inside of Vic Hill. That's a battle for the third spot. Put Kerr back around Hill for position number three. Hill back to four, Stacy Bowles fifth. Chris Madden now moving to the top side of the racing service in turn three and four, and he'll get up against the fluff in turn one and two as well. Ogle second, Kerr is third. Stacy Bowles around Vic Hill for the fourth spot as Bowles is making the bottom side of the racing service work for his race car. Meanwhile, the front three of Madden, Ogle, and a Kerr putting some distance now on the fourth place Munich machine of Stacy Bowles. Vic Hill fifth. Mike Weeks holds down sixth. Mark Vineyard seventh. Hunter Peacock eighth. Jason Hyatt is ninth. Josh Collins now in tenth. Yes, we've got 14 cars of the original 21 starters still on a racing surface. One lap past the midpoint of this one. Vic Hill trying to work back to the inside of Stacy Bowles, side by side for the third and fourth spot here off turn four, coming at you down the front straightaway. Bowles laying on to the third, fourth position for the time being. Meanwhile, up front, Chris Madden continues to show the way. He's got about eight, nine car lengths on the 201 of Billy Ogle Jr. And then it's several car lengths back to the 14 of Tommy Kerr, and Kerr with about a half straightaway back to fourth place, Stacy Bowles. Chris Madden, who's got clean racetrack at the moment. But if we stay green, that's going to change because he is going to catch the rear of the field here very quickly. And sparks from beneath the H1 of Jason Hyatt as he slows going down the back straightaway. He's up on the top side of the racing surface. Don't know if that's going to draw a caution flag or not. And caution is out for the H1 of Jason Hyatt. We got 14 trips remaining here in the 4th Annual Charles Trammell Memorial as we get set to come back to green, and here we go. Chris Madden leads him down the back straightaway. Billy Ogle Jr. second, Tommy Kerr third, Stacy Bowles fourth, and here comes Hunter Peacock looking to make his way into the top five, and he'll have that done. 15 starting, Hunter Peacock now rides in the fifth position. Mike Weeks is sixth. Riley Hickman, who started 17th, rides in 7th. Yes, here on this restart, Madden and Ogle have scooted away a bit from the 3rd place machine of Tommy Kerr. Yes, when they roll by this time, there'll be 11 laps to go, 11 to go in the 4th Annual Charles Trammell Memorial. Chris Madden looking high, wide, and handsome at this point. As they work off turn number four, 10 to go in the 4th Annual Charles Trammell Memorial for the Southern All-Stars here at Tazewell Speedway. Madden the leader, Ogle second. Tommy Kerr third, Stacy Bowles fourth. 15th starting, Hunter Peacock fifth, Mike Weeks sixth. 17th starting, Riley Hickman is seventh. Mark Vineyard eighth. Jeff Wolfenbarger and Josh Collins battling for 9th and 10th, and it's Mark Rosner and Brent Holmes with 8 to go. If we stay green, race leader Chris Madden may catch the rear of the field before this one's over. Kerr and Bowles make some contact up in turn one and two. And third place running Tommy Kerr has rolled to a stop, and that's going to draw the caution flag. And the leader, Ogle second, Bowles third, Peacock fourth, Weeks fifth.
Then it's Riley Hickman, Mark Vineyard, Josh Collins, Jeff Wolfenbarger, Mark Rosner, and Brett Holmes. Eyes on them off turn four, and here we go. 8 laps to remain. Chris Madden has led it all the way, and Billy Ogle Jr. has dogged him with all of his effort, but has not been able to find a way around Madden at any point in the contest. He got close a couple of times back around lap 20, but has not been able to mount a charge since then. We'll have 6 to go this time. Madden and Ogle run 1-2. Bowles is third, Peacock fourth, Weeks fifth. As the lap's winding down here now in this one. Five to go in the fourth annual Charles Trammell Memorial, and it is all Chris Madden out in front still. Billy Ogle Jr. second, then it's several car lengths back to third place running Stacy Bowles, who has a pretty good advantage over fourth place running Hunter Peacock is Mike Weeks and Riley Hickman go at it for the fifth and sixth spots in the 22 and R1 respectively off turn two down the back straightaway. 3 laps remain. Chris Madden and Billy Ogle Jr., they're going to settle the issue amongst themselves as they work off turn number 4. There'll be 2 laps remaining here in this one. 2 to go in the Charles Trammell Memorial. Chief starter Bruce Kaler with the white flag in hand as they get set to work off turn number 4. White is out. 1 lap to settle the issue in this one. Yes, Brent Hyatt. Well, pull to the inside and let the leaders race for the win down the back straightaway in turns 3 off of turn 4. The Charles Trammell Memorial win will go to Chris Smokey Madden. Billy Ogle Jr. will come home in second. Stacy Bowles going to finish in third. Hunter Peacock will be fourth. And Mike Weeks will come home in fifth.
And congratulations, your Team Blomquist race car extremely fast tonight. The only car under 11 seconds in WhitePerformance.com time trials. And looked like your race car just kept getting better and better the more laps that you could click off under the green flag there.
Yeah, we had a great race car all night long. Was able to go, fast time and qualifying. That's really important here to be up front. And, when you take a good car like this and start up front, it's hard for them guys to pass. But the racetrack was great tonight. Our car was great. And the bottom finally wore out there, and we were able to move up on top. And I knew if we was able to hold on as long as the groove was in the bottom, we'd be okay when we went to the top.
Billy Ogle Jr. ran second to you there for a majority of the race and showed you the nose there a couple of times around the midpoint of the race over in turn 2 and over in turn 4. And I think it's like you said, the top kind of cleaned off there a little bit for you guys, and you was able to keep your momentum up on the top side and keep Ogle behind you.
Yeah, me and Billy, we've had some tough races, man, that guy's good in this part of the country, and when you can beat him around here, you've done a pretty good job. And, them guys have been running real well. I like racing with them guys. He's a heck of a racer.
No, you got some sponsors you need to thank, and we'll let you do that and get this Victory Lane celebration underway.
Yeah, I want to thank Century Plastics, All-Star Performance, Henderson Amusement, Hamricks of Gaffney, Blomquist Race Cars, Clements Automotive, Sammy at Precision Suspension with JRI, and East Coast Entertainment, Hoosier Dirt Tire South, VP Fuels.
Again, race fans here at Tazewell.
All these guys that come every week and work hard, we've been struggling a little bit. They've hung in there with me, and we come up here with a different program, and they paid off tonight.
Well, it looks like you definitely got it pointing back in the right direction, Chris Madden. Again, race fans here at Tazewell Speedway, give him a big round of applause. Winner of the 4th Annual Charles Trammell Memorial with the Southern All-Stars here at Tazewell Speedway out of Grace Court, South Carolina, Chris Smokey Madden.
A few words, second place effort. Congratulations, Billy Ogle Jr. here this evening.
Your Blount Motorsports race car worked pretty good for you tonight. The bottom kind of played to your hands there. It looked like around the midpoint of the race you were able to get there on the inside and get a few runs at Madden for the race lead. But as he talked about there in his interview, the top kind of cleaned off there a little bit, and he was able to keep that momentum up on the top side.
Yeah, there midways, I thought I was going to maybe get by him, and then I started slipping right where he was slipping. And, we were struggling there. And then, like he said, the top started cleaning off. And I felt like I could beat him in 1 and 2, but he was beating me in 3 and 4. But I think if I could have got close to him, we might have got side by side down here. But passing him and getting there is two different things. But, you know, he did what he needed to, and I knew the top was going to start getting better and better as the race went. I didn't know where I needed to start on the restarts. I was kind of iffy up and down, and I finally went back to the bottom. I don't know if that was where it was at or not, but I was able to hold on to second anyway, and glad to get second. Wanted to win, but I'm happy for second.
All right, then, congratulations. Great job tonight, Billy Ogle Jr. Picking up a runner-up run tonight. Stacy Bowles, third-place finish in your 11B machine. And I know you got to be tickled to death with where you started out tonight and where you was able to finish. You was able to be in the right place in the right time there a few times. Your race car pretty quick tonight.
Yeah, we wasn't bad. We gambled on the right rear tire. I've looked. We went harder than all these guys, and it kind of paid off there at the end, you know, because I could see them trying to get down here in cooler tires, and they were struggling to where we was still fast, you know. But, you know, we had a little too much gear in the car from qualifying. We should have took it out, and just a few little odds in the end, we could have been a whole lot better. But we'll take it. We had a good night.
No, it looked like there. I could see where you talked about the hard right rear tire, because it looked like there at the end, you all ran the last 13 to 14 laps, I think, green. And the more green flag laps you made, the faster your race car got, because that tire started to fire.
Yeah, and I needed that to stay green, but it seemed like, you know, about the time we would start picking up tents, the caution would come out, and then it would take a few laps to get going, then a caution. But we needed the long green, which we got there at the end, and got us third, and we'll take it and go with it.
All right, then, congratulations, Stacy Bowles, third place finisher in the night's Charles Trammell Memorial here at Tazewell Speedway.
Front row, 20 lap sportsman feature. Looking for the green this time by. Out. Pure Street. And it looks like he'll probably go to the rear end of the field. Last week's winner, Key Chapman, now moves up to the front row alongside the triple five of Ryan Carey. Green in the air this time by. We are underway. Rescue squad needs you on the front stretch. If you are not a track official, please stay off of the track. Again, if you are not, step away from the fence. If you are not a track official, rescue squad, we need you off the track. Rescue squad saying the driver is okay. Mike Kelly is okay after taking a wild ride down there in turn number one. And rescue squad and track officials able to get to him quickly. And folks down there in turn number one, if you will, please step back. There's pieces of the fence there, and we don't want anybody injured down there. Main thing is Mike Kelly is okay after that wild wreck. And another caution comes out. Last week's winner, Keith Chapman, slows on the back stretch.
Right side.
Okay. Matt Shockley had moved up into the second spot and spins on his own over in turn number two. And Ryan Kopic spins along
over
as well.
Over in turn number two.
Ryan Carey is still your leader. Ryan Kopic now moves up in the second. And looking for the green this time by Ryan Carey, your leader, followed by Ryan Kopic and Aaron Gwynn. And a big mess over in turn one as we got involved in that. Matt Shockley, the 007, the 2C. Ryan Kopic also involved the 8 of Aaron Gwynn. Brought out as the 2C. It spun and collected the 007 of Matt Shockley. Also involved in that, the 8 of. All right, so we get the 007 of Matt Shockley off the track. We'll close the gate. Field should get the one to go signal. Looking for the green next time by 9 laps down. 6 more to go. Ryan Carey, your leader. Can he hang on for 6 more laps to pick up his first late model win here at the Bad Fast Tazewell Speedway? Caution once again as Ryan Kopic spins on his own over in turn number two. Looking for a late night snack or something to take home with you. Large pizzas. Large whole pizzas are only $8. Again, large whole pizzas. Carey, half a lap away from his first late model victory. As Aaron Gwynn slows on the front stretch, here they come for the checkered flag. And there's your winner, Aaron, Ryan Carey. Keith Chapman wind up second, Aaron Gwynn third. Here he comes out, folks. Let's give a hand for your first winner tonight. First win ever for Ryan Carey. How about that, man? Second generation driver coming out here tonight, leading every lap. I know you couldn't wait for that race to get over. Ryan, how's it feel to be your get your first win here at Tazewell Speedway?
Feels great. You know, we probably practiced this speech 100 times in the middle. It tickles to death. I was first of all want to thank the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I told him that if I'd ever win a race, I'd give my testimony in the winner's circle, and I'm certainly glad he saved me one day at a crusade when I was in fourth grade. I'm certainly thankful for that. I'd like to thank my dad, Carrie's Custom, it's his car, my motor, Steve Smith, Mark Vineyard. You know, they helped me, you know, try to guide me in the right way. Certainly thankful for the win. Thank you guys for coming out and watching.
And, of course, your dad had many laps here, and you watched him over the years. Had a practice here a few weeks ago, and you did good in that. But coming out here tonight, you were fast and hot laps, fast and qualifying, and this car was just superb tonight. And get over here and enjoy the pictures. And once again, congratulations on your first win.
Thank you, Tazewell Speedway.
Folks, one more time, let's give a hand for Ryan Carey. First win here at Tazewell Speedway. All right, field bunches up nicely. Last time they didn't around, but now they're bunching up nicely. Here we come. Jason Saylor, Steve Smith looking for the green, and we are underway. A pure street feature, 20 laps. Side by side, they go to turn number one. Steve Smith pulls ahead. We've got several cars getting together over to turn number two. They're all able to continue. The C5 of Daniel Carpenter, and also involved that, the 26 of Jonathan Miracle. And we got a spin over in turn number four. And the caution will come out. And so, coming up on four laps in the book, Jason Saylor, your leader. Daniel Carpenter in second, Jason Long third, your pole sitter, Steve Smith fourth, and Jonathan Miracle round out your top five. Jason Saylor, the driver out of Kentucky, looking for his first ever win here at Tazewell Speedway. Right now, he is showing the way with five laps in the books. Steve Smith trying to look to the inside of Jason Long down in 3 and 4, trying to take that third spot away. Long shuts the door. Jason Saylor still out front. Daniel Carpenter second. And we've got a battle going on for that third spot. Jason Long trying to hold off Steve Smith, last week's winner. Now Smith backs off a little bit and loses ground on third place, Jason Long. Up front, Daniel Carpenter in that C5, starting to gain some ground on your leader, Jason Saylor. Now, as we go 10 laps in the books, the top four all bunched together. Coming out of two, Steve Smith pulls to the inside of Jason Long, trying to take that third spot away, and he does.
Pick him up.
Twelve laps down. Jason Saylor still your leader. Steve Smith now challenging Daniel Carpenter for a second spot. Your pole sitter now trying to work his way back up to the front. Coming around complete lap 13. Now we got a battle for that second spot as Steve Smith now goes up door-to-door with Daniel Carpenter down the back stretch. Here they come out, turn number four, door-to-door. Carpenter still the advantage, holding on that second spot. 14 down, six more to go. Jason Saylor still up front, but he's got a battle right in his rearview mirror. Steve Smith looking to the inside of Daniel Carpenter once again. Door to door at the flagman stand. And they're still side by side. Now as they come out of turn number two, Steve Smith able to pull ahead as we get a car spinning over in turn number two as the caution flies. Steve Smith, your pole sitter, had worked his way past Jason Long for the third spot. And all right, back to green. Jason Saylor, steering leader. Now Steve Smith pulls up a long slide, challenging him for that lead. Last week's winner, Steve Smith, as they battle door-to-door down the back stretch. Two by one by side-by-side. Here they come to flagman stand. Too close to call. 16 laps down, four more to go. Steve Smith challenging Daniel Jason Saylor for that lead. Gains the advantage down the back stretch. Now here comes Saylor on the outside trying to take that top spot back. As they come by the start-finish line, door-to-door, too close to call. And again, they battle side by side with Smith getting the advantage once again on the back stretch. Right here's where Saylor could get back around. Now Steve Smith throws the block. Steve Smith still your leader. Now Saylor slips back into the second spot. Making it two in a row in our Pure Street feature. Folks, give your hand tonight, your winner, Steve Smith. the win last weekend, and that had to work for a little bit, Steve. You and Jason putting on a good show. They're racing good and clean, but making it two in a row and working for it, but you look good, brother.
I appreciate it, yeah. That was probably the hardest one I've won in a while. I couldn't get around them on top, so I had to go to the bottom, try it, and I got just enough to get on around them.
And just enough sometimes is all you need, brother.
Yeah, I want to thank everybody that helps me here. I got Shane's Body Shop, got Billy Gordon Construction, I got Bob's Roofing, and I just want to thank everybody for helping me out and all these guys that helps me in the garage all week long. I want to thank all of them.
Takes a lot of hard work to get these cars here every week. Folks, one more time, give a hand tonight for your Pure Street winner, two in a row for Steve Smith.